So this was really open-ended project, and because I had no pressure from the client, I would just try whatever I wanted, and whatever the team wanted, rather. The ideas were coming from everywhere, and out of that, of course, there was a hierarchy. Some things worked, some things didn't work. So maybe 40-50% of the things that we tried, we discarded actually. We didn't use it in the end. But yeah, this is what the so yeah, for the Idol itself, because I was not so experienced with human forms and animal forms, I actually invited an origami artist from Vietnam to make the idol. So this is all made out of paper. And also, there's a mural artist from Bangalore called Anpu, who I invited to introduce some sort of imagery from the legend of Mahishasura Mardini, which is the story of Durga and the demon. This is actually the entrance way to go in. And you can see there are some lights at the floor for the steps. So at a lot of places, we had vibration sensors and weight sensors, so counting the number of people that are going in and how frequently they're going in. So the system is very integrated. The interactive system is very integrated. So if there are very few people, it is very reactive. You know, small things create large results. But if because you know there's a lot of variation in the number of people that come during Durga Puja. In the evening, sometimes there are like hundreds and thousands of people. There was like queues of thousands of people standing to go in, and then we had to start regulating how many people are going in. So when there's that kind of a rush, we wanted the system to not become cacophonic, you know. So if the sensors get triggered too often, then the overall system becomes harder to trigger. Everything becomes harder to trigger. But if there are fewer people, then it's easier to trigger. There's some details of the ceiling. And just playing with very simple lighting, mostly all yellow lights, which I did my on my own, the lighting design. Is my team, not all of them, of course, but yeah, it was this is one of my, I think, most satisfying project in terms of teamwork. Where you know that the hierarchy that is there often in most creative field today, actually creative industry is a bit strange, because I find that designers and architects, you know, are sitting on this high pedestal, and then they are giving out these fatwas about how things should be designed or made, while the person who's making it is sort of pressurized with this tender contract process, and so innovation really takes a backseat on site. I mean, of course, there are exceptions, but generally speaking, I find that the designer is very far away from the user and the fabricator. While if you look at vernacular practice, actually, there's a very close link between the maker, the designer, the fabricator, the user. They're all the same group, or just doing things for each other. So there's a different understanding of how things should be made, how things should be used. That's about it. I'll just